Welcome back to the channel, guys. We're going to jump right into it here with installing and using Lutris on desktop and in game mode. And just like with many other things, we need to get started in desktop mode. So let's go ahead and get into power here, and we're going to go to switch to desktop, and we'll get moved over there where we can get started. Now, once you're on desktop mode, you can go ahead and move over and go to your Discovery app. And I do like to make sure fetching for updates finishes, because it tends to slow the Discovery app search down a lot if you don't. All right, there we go. So now we're going to click on applications here, and then I'm just going to search for Lutris here in the search bar. So we'll type that out. I'll hit enter, and now Lutris will show up for us over here. Everything's looking good, so we'll click install if you haven't gotten this already, and you'll be good to go. There's a few tasks it'll go through to install. It takes a little bit, not too long, and then you'll be good to go. But once that finishes up and says it's done, we'll have a launch button here. So I'll go ahead and click launch. I can close out of my Discovery app. And now Lutris will do its checking for updates thing here and get launched up for the first time on this Steam Deck. Now, I'm not going to go deep into settings and all the other different things you can do with Lutris in this particular video. I really just wanted to go into installing it and using it, adding it to Steam and in game mode. But one thing I will do in here is get to dark mode, because I really need Lutris to be in dark mode for me. So we want to go up to the top where those three lines are at. We're going to click that, and we're going to go to preferences. It's going to be useful for you anyway when you get into using all the different settings, but I'm going to go down here and go to use dark theme. We'll check that off, and there we go. That will definitely help me out. So now that we're in dark mode, I'm going to go ahead and click here to connect, which is just going to go ahead and queue me up the install for Epic. There's other ways you can queue that up in here as well, but I just happen to do it that way in this video. But we want to go ahead and install Epic. This is just an example. Whatever installer you're installing, Ubisoft, Epic, EA App, whatever, I'm going to be going over more of those in another video here shortly. You can take note of where everything's being installed here. I'll go ahead and click install, and then this process does seem to take a few minutes through all the steps, and after this you'll get this double download, or at least I did. I go ahead and continue and move on with this, let it do all of that, and then once it gets this part done, it goes to the Wine setup, getting that configured and ready to go for the first time here as well. And then after that, we do have another step where it goes in installing all the dependencies. Like I said, I'm skipping through a lot of this on the video. It's just prompts and a little bit of time to go through this. But once it's finished, you'll get the launch right here. Everything's good to go. And you can see Windows has been added to platforms at the bottom of Lutris there. And we can add all of our different launchers in right there. So here we go. Epic, go ahead and open up for the first time. It's doing its update and all that. And I didn't have any problems with this running and working for me here. And then we'll go ahead and sign into the Epic account. So I'll sign into my account. And then here we go. I am into Epic and my library is here. Everything's good, ready to go for install. So we'll go ahead and go in here and we'll just pick a game to download. This is all just for example. To show you everything working here with Lutris and get you guys started. So I'll just pick Crisis Remastered here. It's not a big download. Go ahead and click install, make sure everything's working properly. Now, first time here, it does take a little bit to kind of pull up the storage options, but not too bad. Once that does that, you can install and it's default here as it chose, or you can go and put it on an SD card or in a different file or whatever you want there. It's pretty easy to navigate and get around and access what you need to here. But I'm just sticking with the SSD and all the standard install stuff. I really don't like the SD performance when it comes to like the third-party stuff as much as I do regular SteamOS games. But we'll go ahead and get that installed here, and we'll see the download start. I'll show you guys that real quick. All right, we'll go ahead and click downloads. I'll show you that process happening here. And there you go, we're installing Crisis. Now let's speed forward here and get to the end. So it's all done installing, it's ready to go, but I'm going to close out of Epic here. And I did want to show you one more side note. If you go here back to this connect button, if you were to sign in right here, you would actually be able to see your game library over here in Lutris, not just by opening up Epic. And this works with the other launchers and stuff as well. Not something I'm getting into this video, but I did want to mention that to you so you can go a little deeper yourself there. But down here on Windows platforms, we do have Epic all ready to go and launch, and we're good for gaming here on desktop mode with Lutris and our launchers. But if you want to use this in game mode, it's time to go to the next steps. So we're going to open up Steam here, and if you're used to this with your Steam Deck already, we do need to add a non-Steam game. So we'll click add a game, add a non-Steam game, and Lutris is going to show up right here since it is a natively installed app. Add selected program, and then it will show up in our list over here for Lutris. Now, you guys know I like to keep things pretty clean when I get back to game mode, so I'm going to add in my custom artwork here. So right here, we're going to add in the banner size icon. We'll put that here for Lutris. I'm going to go into my properties, and we're going to add our icon. Now, I made all these the proper size as I usually do, and I typically throw these in the Discord channel if people want to go grab them, but we'll pick our icon here. So I'll go down. There we go. Proper size for the icon. Now we have two more places if we want this to look clean when we go back to game mode, and that's going to be right down here in our recent game. So let me actually launch Lutris and close it. There we go. It's in recent games, manage, set custom artwork. And again, you'll use the banner size here if you want to fill that properly. And then we need it to bump over. So I'm going to open GeForce Now and close it. Pushes Lutris over here to the last spot where we need to put the capsule size. All right, there we go. So now it's in all four places and it'll look nice and clean over in game mode. So let's go ahead, restart the Steam Deck and get over into game mode now that we're ready. And you can see Lutris installed here. I'm going to click play and it launches very quickly here in game mode. Now, one problem you'll run into is you'll have to use touchscreen because off the bat, the control scheme doesn't allow you to use the trackpads or anything else or the controller. So let me move this overlay out of the way and we're going to go ahead and go in, make a couple of two easy changes that will help you navigate this just a little bit to get started, and your controller will still work in game. So we're going to hit the Steam button to bring up the game's menu here and go to controller settings. We're going to go up where it says gamepad with joystick trackpad. I'm going to change that to gamepad with mouse trackpad. It's just an easy way to do it here. And then as soon as I do that, you'll see my mouse show up. I can actually use the right trackpad now to navigate, but clicking doesn't do anything yet. And we do want to be able to left click to open and select options. So go back into those controller settings, edit layout, go down the trackpads, and go to where it says click right here. Okay, so we're using that as a mouse. Now we're going to click on here to change that setting, and we're going to tab over to where it says mouse, and I'm going to select left mouse click because that's what I want clicking the right trackpad to do for me. So now that I've done that, I can go back, and now you'll see not only can I move around, I can actually click with that trackpad and open things up, and it works. So there you go. Everything's working well for me here in game mode as well for Lutris. I can launch my games, install my games, do everything from here, uninstall my games, or I can do the same thing over in desktop mode. So let's go ahead and let Crysis launch up here. And I am interested to test and play more games through Lutris this way with the other launchers because it's been pretty fast. It's been working pretty decent. I am running off the SSD with everything, and game performance has been decent in a couple of games that I've been playing around with. So I'm looking forward to getting into that more here with Lutris and playing around with that more. And I'll definitely have more videos on installing stuff and performance and that type of thing. But anyways, guys, I hope this video helps you get Lutris going on desktop mode and in game mode for your Steam Deck. Thanks a lot for coming and check it out as always, and I'll see you guys in the next one.